أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. My name is Dr. Azhar Ali, Assistant Professor, Electrical Engineering Department, Sarhad University, Peshawar. Dear students, today we are going to learn about first order linear differential equations. And this is the first lecture of fifth week for the course Applied Mathematics 2. Now, dear students, till now what we have done in the previous lectures for the course Applied Mathematics 2, let's call them first. In the previous lectures, we have done about the solution of first order differential equations and important forms of methods through which we can know the form of equations and then use or apply the method which is required. So in the previous lectures we have discussed about the separable differential equations, homogeneous equations and exact differential equations and its solution procedures. Now today we are going to learn about the fourth class of first order differential equation, which is called first order linear differential equations. So today now I would like to tell you about the separable equations, homogeneous equation and exact differential equations, and I would like to repeat the solutions procedures. So separable equations and its solution procedure. A separable first order differential equation has the form dy by dx is equal to g of x divided by h of y. Dear students, we have already discussed all these three forms, separable equations, homogeneous equation and exact equations. But I would like to these three forms and its solution procedure and then come to the solutions of first order differential equations. Now the solutions procedure for the separable equation form is that first of all write this equation in the form h of y dy is equal to h of x dx. This step means that for the separation of variable, join the h function to the operator dy and join the g function to the operator dx. Since h is a function of y, so join the h function to the operator dy and g is the function of x, so join this function to the operator dy. And these two operator will be not in the denominator form. Now, since separable form is possible in this differential equation, so after separation of variable, taking integration on both sides, taking the integration of this function with respect to y and the integration of this g function with respect to x, and then applying integration, you will get the solution of this differential equation for y. And at the last, use initial condition to solve for c. Initial condition allow us to find the value of c. If the given differential equation is an initial value problem, then use that initial condition to find the value of c, which will be appear in the solution of the given differential equation. Now, homogeneous differential equation and its solution procedure. The condition of homogeneous function is suppose we have a function of lambda x comma lambda y. If this function can be written as lambda power n f of x y, then the function will be called homogeneous function and n is the degree of this homogeneous function. Now for the differential equation, a differential equation of the form m dy plus n dx is equal to 0. This differential equation will be homogeneous if m and n, if m and n is homogeneous function and have the same degree, then the given differential equation will be homogeneous. Now, dear students, since I have already told you in the previous lectures that for the solution of homogeneous differential equation, first of all, write the equation in the y in the form of y by x, and use this substitution: y by x is equal to v, then y is equal to vx, and after taking the derivative, we get dy is equal to x dv plus v dx. And this step means that dy by dx is equal to v plus x dv by dx. And substituting in the given equation, the equation will be separable equation. So separable variables, and then integrate to find the solution. Now, for the exact differential equation, a differential equation of the form m dx plus n dy is equal to 0 will be exact if partial m by partial y is equal to partial n by partial x. If these two partial derivatives are equal, then the given differential equation will be exact, and then we can find its solution easily by taking the integration of m function with respect to x and integration of n function, but those term of n which not containing x, with respect to y is equal to c. Now, dear students, sometime the partial derivative of m does not equal to the partial derivative of n with respect to x, then the given differential equation not exact, will be a non-exact differential equation. Then the equation will be non-exact, and to convert it to the exact form, multiply it by an integral factor and then solve this differential equation, the given differential equation. Dear students, I have already told you about the non-exact differential equation, that if a differential equation is non-exact, then transform the non-exact differential equation into the exact form by multiplying an integral factor. But the question is that how to find an integral factor. I have already told you in the last four lectures that first of all, find an integral factor by using the four cases. We have already discussed the four cases. The four cases are finding for the integral factor and then multiplying the integral factor to the exact differential, the non-exact differential equation. Then the non-exact differential equation will become an exact differential equation, and then find its solution easily by taking integration of m term with respect to x, and the integration of n term, but that term of n which not containing x with respect to y is equal to c. Now, this is the fourth class of first order linear differential equation, which is called first order linear differential equations. A differential equation m dx plus n dy is equal to 0 will be linear if these three conditions hold. Number one, the dependent variable y and its derivative occur in the first degree only. Number two, the product of y and its derivative are absent. Number three, no transcendental function of y and its derivative are present. Since in this differential equation, y is a dependent variable, so we discuss all these three conditions for y. The dependent variable y and its derivative occurs in the first degree only, the product of y and its derivative are absent, and the third condition is that no transcendental function of y and its derivative are present. Now, the general form of first order linear differential equation is that dy by dx plus p of x into y is equal to q of x. Dear students, this is the general form of first order linear differential equation. So, for the solution procedure, the integral factor that can convert the linear equation to exact equation is, first of all, find the linear effect, integral factor. For the integral factor, suppose mu is a linear as a integral factor, then the integral factor will be exponential e power p of x dx. Integrate the p function with respect to x, and then write a simple you can write for the integral factor e power integration of p function with respect to x. Then after finding the integral factor, multiplying the integral factor to the to this given linear differential equation, and simply we can find its solution by using this formula. Mu, this is the integral factor, multiplied y is equal to integration of mu dot the q function with respect to x plus c. Now let's move an example. Suppose we have a first order linear differential equation y dash plus y secant x is equal to cos square x, where y dash mean dy by dx. Now compare this given differential equation to the general form of linear differential equation dy by dx. This term mean dy by dx plus p into y, this is p, is equal to q, this is the q function. So the p function is equal to secant x and the q function is a cos square x. Now find the integral factor. Exponential integration of p function, exponential power e power integration of the p function with respect to x. This representation mean that e power integration of p function with respect to x. So taking the integration of the p function, the p function is equal to secant x, and the integration of secant is equal to natural log of secant plus tangent. Now e power log of secant x plus tangent x, we obtain the integral factor is secant x plus tangent x. Now the general solution of this given linear differential equation will be integral factor dot y is equal to integration of integral factor dot q with respect to x plus c. So putting the value of the integral factor, this is the value of integral factor, secant x plus tangent x, this is the right hand side, left hand side, secant x plus tangent x dot y is equal to integration of mu, this is the integral factor, and this is the q function, integration of this with respect to x. Now after simplification, dear students, you know secant mean 1 over cos multiplied cos square, cos cancel, we obtain cos x, plus tangent mean sine by cos, so cos and cos cancel, we obtain sin x cos x, and the integration of cos x is equal to sin x, and the integration of sine function multiplied cos function is equal to 1 over 2 sin square x plus c. So this is the solution of the given first order linear differential equation. So dear student, first of all compare the given differential equation to the general form of linear differential equation. You can easily find out that the given differential equation is a linear differential equation. Now second example, suppose we have an example x dy by dx plus y plus 4 is equal to 0. First of all, rewrite this differential equation into the general form for the comparison to the general form of linear differential equation. So dividing both sides by x, we obtain dy by dx plus y by x minus 4 by x. Now dear students, note that to compare this differential equation to the general form, we obtain that the p function here is 1 over x and the q function is minus 4 by x. Now find the integral factor. E power integration of p function with respect to x, e power 1 over x dx is equal to e power log of x, which is equal to x. So this is the integral factor. Now dear students, multiplying this integral factor to the given linear differential equation, we obtain x dy by dx plus y by x into x. Dear students, this is the standard form of given differential equation. So multiplying the integral factor, here we obtain x dy by dx plus y by x into x minus 4x. X or x cancel. Now, dear students, note that in the left hand side, this expression mean that this is the derivative by inspection method. You see here that this is the derivative of the function y by x. If we taking the derivative of y by x by using product rule, we again obtain this expression. For example, first derivative of second plus second and derivative of first. First derivative of second plus second derivative of first. Here you see here this is 1. X and x cancel, we get y dot 1. So first, if x is the first function and y is the second, then by using the product rule we obtain first derivative of second plus second. Second is the y function and derivative of first, the first function is x, so the derivative of x with respect to x will be 1. And dear students, you see here that this is equal to 1. X and x cancel, we get y dot 1. N minus 4 is it is. Now you can easily find its solution by taking integration. We obtain y by x minus 4, integration of minus 4 is minus 4x plus c, and this is equal to y dot x minus 4 plus c by x. And dear students, you can find the solution of this differential equation by using this formula, that the integral factor dot y, integral factor is x, so integral factor dot y is equal to an integration of integral factor dot q, integration of integral factor dot q. This is the q function. So x and x cancel, and the integration of 4 is equal to 4x. Integration of minus 4 is equal to minus 4x. So you can see here, you can find the solution of this differential expression by taking the derivative of the function y by x. This is the derivative of the function y by x, and we can find its solution by using this formula also. Now dear students, another example. To solve this differential equation, cos x dy by dx plus sin x into y is equal to c. First of all, write this differential equation in the standard form, which obtain dy by dx plus sin divided by cos x, multiplying both sides by cos x, which is on the right hand side, we obtain 1 over cos x. Now sin by cos mean tangent. So to compare this differential equation to the general form, to the standard form of linear differential equation, here you see that the p function is tangent x, and the q function is 1 over cos x. So first of all, find the integral factor. The integral factor mean e power integration of the p function, and p function is now tangent x. So the integration of tangent function is equal to minus log of cos x, and we obtain here e power log of cos x whole power minus 1, and here after simplification we get cos x power minus 1, which is equal to 1 over cos x. Now multiplying this integral factor to equation number 1. 1 over cos x dy by dx plus sin by cos square x dot y is equal to 1 over cos square. And dear students, again you see here that this differential expression, this is the derivative of the 1 over cos dot y. So by inspection method, easily we find here that this differential expression, this is the derivative of 1 over cos x dot y. So using again the product rule, we get this differential expression, and 1 over cos square is as it is. 1 over cos square is equal to secant square. And dear students, you can use the formula, integral factor is 1 over cos integral factor dot y is equal to the q function dot integral factor. This is the integral factor and this is the q function. So we can find the solution easily by using this formula, that integral factor dot y is equal to integration of integral factor dot q with respect to x plus c. So after integrating, now here this is the differential, this is the derivative of 1 over cos x dot y. So integrating we get 1 over cos dot y and integration of secant square, and this is equal to y divided by cos x is equal to the integration of secant square as a tangent x plus c, and this is equal to y is equal to cos x dot tangent x plus c cos x, and again it can be written as y is equal to sin x plus c into cos x, and this is the general solution of the given linear differential equation. So dear students, if the inspection method is complicated, so since the inspection method is complicated for the students, so you can find its solution easily by using the formula after finding the integral factor, that the solution of the linear differential equation will be integral factor dot y. So since this is the integral factor, now integral factor dot y is equal to integration of integral factor dot the q function, since this is the q function, 1 over cos x is the q function. So integration of integral factor dot q, integral factor is 1 over cos and q function is also 1 over cos. So 1 over cos multiplied 1 over cos is equal to 1 over cos square, and 1 over cos square mean secant square. So you can use the formula for the solution of linear differential equation after multiplying the integral factor. So when we find the integral factor, then find the solution of the linear differential equation easily by using this formula, that integral factor multiplied the dependent variable is equal to integration of integral factor multiplied q function with respect to x. So this is the integral factor dot y is equal to integration of integral factor dot q function. Q function is 1 over cos, integral factor is also 1 over cos. So 1 over cos multiplying 1 over cos mean 1 over cos square, and 1 over cos square mean secant square. So the integration of secant square easily equal to tangent x plus c. So this is the solution of the given linear differential equation, and this is the end of this segment. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.